are you doing, Ben? To be here this evening. Thank you, and you're a very beautiful part of the world. Just want to have you, I just want to say a huge personal thank you and a fucking here enormous round of applause for the incredible artist and bright light that is Allison Russell. Yeah. Allison is a dear friend and just an incredible artist and soul and somebody I'm so proud to be on the road with and sharing these shows with. Thank you so much for being such an incredible audience for Allison Russell. For you. This is a song that was just released like last week.
Thank you.
Feeling good? Back at the lawn? Are you guys up in the driving range? You alright? There's these special tickets that they're sold on a special website. These guys actually have clubs and balls. They're playing top golf up there. And we are the target. Don't be alarmed.
Yeah. couldn't see if.
Thanks very much. This is a song, I'm all tangled up here. This is a song called Francesca. Do you think I give up? But this might have shook the love from me. That I was on the brink. How could you think? Darling, I'd scare so easily. Now that it's done, there's not one thing that I would change. My life was a storm since I was born. How could I feel? Older one. Thank you, man. I love you too. This is great. In this light and from this distance, it's kind of like, I know you're used to seeing those things, but it's like there's like three very distant skyscrapers with a terrible use of space, you know? They're nice though. You can sort of see it. Imagine you'd never been here before. There you go. Now you can see it.
Say to me,
anything could fall at all, it's the world that falls away from me. You have me floating like a feather on the sea, while you're as heavy as the world that you hold your hands beneath. Once I had wondered what was holding up the ground, I can see that all along though, it was you all the way down. Leave it now, I am skybound. If you need to, darling, lean your weight to me. We'll float away, but if we fall, I only pray, don't fall away from me. I do not have wings of anger. Soaring over a world you are carrying. If these heights should bring our fall, let me be your own. I carry you, carry you. If the wind turns, if I hit a squall, allow the ground to find its brutal way to me. If I should fall on that day, I only pray, don't fall away. Violin by the wonderful Mr. Kellen Wembrick, and on cello by the very wonderful Larissa Maestro. It's rent these days, you know. Can you imagine up there? This is an older song. You get a good view of the gigs though, I suppose. Fierce height to drop from though, you know. Yeah. a beautiful band. Thank you very much. You know, I love that. We got you guys. If you guys mind making a bit of space for some folks there, that'd be amazing. Good looking out. Yeah. So, I gotta tell you, I fucking love coming to Oregon because I'm not blowing smoke. There's enough of that going around. I mean it. It's just because, like, your weather, you have nicer summers than Ireland, but we're on a very similar sort of, you know, kind of. We have very similar rest of the seasons. You kill us on summers, but, you know, winters, springs, autumns are very like Ireland, you know? And the kind of Northwest in general is just like, I feel like kind of at home, you know? And you're no stranger to rain, you know? And I think, generally, where you go, where the weather is a bit shit, people are generally a little bit more sound. They're kind of like, they have a dry sense of humor a lot of the time. They're kind of more down to earth. That's just my, I'm just spitballing here, but that's just my working theory. But generally, I just feel more at home around people who are used to rain, you know? And you guys seem to be. But I wrote this next song years ago during the kind of early parts of the pandemic. We won't linger on those memories, but it was kind of that time of great distance and the world got very large all of a sudden. And Ireland was kind of blessed with this spectacular summer when we were all locked indoors. And but I wrote this song just kind of trying to make sense of that sense of wanting to be helpful or useful or do something and the sense of the year getting away from us. But it's a special song for me in that it's the first of my own music that I got to share with the absolute bright light, the incredible artist that is Allison Russell. At Newport Folk Festival years ago, and been friends ever since, and I've always admired Allison's work is so urgent and so important and so brilliant, and Allison's one of the kind of great freedom singers of our time, and around the time that we recorded this song, Allison was gracious enough to invite me onto her beautiful track Requiem, a beautiful song called Requiem off her Grammy winning album The Returner. Which is also work done by our very own Larissa Maestro. Also, so it was a nice, sweet time of kind of song swap. This is a song called Wildflower and Barley.
This year I swear it'll be buried in nature.
the month has not much longer now. The sun hesitates more on each evening's darkening. With all things God allows remain above ground, lay grief and sweet memory, wildflower and barley.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Sincere thank you. Anybody who was listening to that song or sharing it or streaming it since it was released a couple of months back. That song is my first number one, and I can take no credit. That's all you. That is all you guys for doing your thing with it. So thank you so much. Thank you. would always hit my ears. It's such an awful sound in the soul, if that's what you call it. One is the ally of the body. Felt nameless as a river, undiscovered underground. The first time that you kissed me, I drank dry.
Thank you.
So I sing on what she burns, like rum on the fire. Hot and fast and angry as she can be, I walk my days on a wire. It looks ugly, but it's clean. Oh mama, don't fuss over me. The way she tells me I'm hers and she's mine. Open hand or closed fist would be fine. The blood is bitter and sweet as cherry wine. Guilty thrown at me while she stains the sheets of some other. Thrown at me so powerfully, just like she throws with the arm of her brother. But I want it. It's a crime. She's not around most of the time. The way she shows me I'm hers and she's mine. Open hand or closed fist would be fine. The blood is red and sweet as cherry wine.
Thank you.
across the floor of any scene. Ignore the vastness between all that can be seen and all that we believe. So I thought you were like an angel to me. It's funny how true colors shine in darkness and in secrecy. If there were scarlet flags, they washed out in the mind of me. Where a blinding light shone on you every night, on either side of my sleep, where you were held from.
Of everything that we have to be thankful for in our respective democracies that has been achieved through protest, you know? And there's so many things that we take for granted, that we enjoy every single day, that once upon a time was not granted, and had to be pushed for, had to be fought for and organized for. And We forget about it all the time. And sometimes these things can be much vilified, and depending on who you're talking to, it can cause people to roll their eyes. But it doesn't matter where you're coming from on the spectrum. There's all these things that we benefit from every single day that protest has given us, you know? We take for granted that every single person should have the right to vote, you know? That wasn't always the case. We take for granted that women should have the right to vote. But it's within living memory, that is in not that long ago, that women couldn't open a bank account without a male guardian signature. Which is unthinkable now. We take for granted that we should have a weekend to look forward to, Saturday and Sunday. That's something that the labor movement had to work tirelessly for. People had to organize for, fight for. We take for granted that members of the LGBTQ plus community should have the same rights as us. Feel welcome in our society. And that took a hell of a lot of people working, but also recognizing the experience of other people and saying, you know what, your experience might be different from mine, but I would want you to feel as safe and secure in this society as I feel, you know? It may not be my experience, but I would want you to enjoy that. And, you know, I don't know if there's anybody here with any Irish heritage or Irish family. So I recorded this with Mavis Staples, who, as you might know, she used to sing before speeches during the American Civil Rights Movement. Her and her family, the Staples singing. Why that was of some particular interest to me as an Irishman, historically, is that that Civil Rights Movement that happened here in the 1960s, that directly inspired the Civil Rights Movement that happened in Northern Ireland very shortly afterwards. Directly inspired it. At a time and place in Northern Ireland where not every single citizen was guaranteed the right to vote. Again, something within living memory. And we've been singing this song in solidarity over these last 10, 11 months. Anybody who would access in that same empathy, that same compassion, that same recognition of somebody else's experience, would reach out to their representatives and say, you know what, no human being should be subject to the kind of violence we're seeing on our TV screens over the last 9 months, 10 months in Gaza. It doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter where you're coming from. It doesn't matter if you're a Palestinian citizen or a Israeli citizen. No human being should be subject to that kind of violence. As I said, I come from Ireland, which has centuries of occupation and occupational history. And the peace process that came about finally in the 1990s, that meant that I grew up on a peaceful island. A huge involvement from the international community, huge involvement from US citizens, huge involvement from the US administration, who was a broker of that peace. So I come from that place of saying, if you feel moved, reach out to your representatives and ask them to support a ceasefire. Ask them to support a meaningful ceasefire and find a solution. I'm coming from that place, it does make a fucking difference. It makes a huge, huge difference. And to let them know where your heart stands on that issue, you know? And in supporting peace and safety and security for everybody in that region, which would of course mean seeing a Palestine that's free from occupation. I want to thank you for letting me speak from the heart. I want to thank you for letting me also witness the kind of everyday goodwill, the everyday kind of solidarity that I see and I experience in Oregon. I see in a crowd like this where people are feeling faint and people are looking after their neighbors. People are looking out for people they don't know, you know? That's that kind of everyday goodwill that I'm talking about. I want to thank you for letting me witness it and for making me feel so welcome here in Oregon. Okay, thank you.
Awaken, it's the light. It is the grounding of a full uncompromising. It's not forgotten of a light. It's not the opening of eyes. It's not the waking, it's the rising. It's not the shade which should be casted. It's the light and it's the obstacle that cares. Heat that drives the light, it's the fire that ignites. It's not the waking, it's the rising. It's not the song, it is the singing. It's the heaven of a human spirit ringing. It is the bringing of a light.
everything that we deny. But not divine, it's not the way it is right.
And I could cry.
Introduce you one more time to this incredible band. I know I've been yapping for a long time. Yes, I know you're just about sick of me now at this point. I'm just fishing for compliments, thank you, I'll keep going. Joining me from Nashville, Tennessee, on keys and organ and vocoder and conga and vocals, please make some noise for incredible Ryan Connors. Joining me from New York City on synth and keys and percussion and vocals, please make some noise for the incredible Joy Morales. Joining me from Nashville, Tennessee, here on violin and guitar and vocals, please make some noise for the incredible Callum Wimerick. Also joining me from Nashville on cello and guitar and mandocello, which is a real instrument that I didn't just make up. And I mentioned guitar, cello, mandocello, and bird song and human song. Make some noise, please, and percussion for the incredible Larissa Maestro. Joining me from the Bahamas via New York City on synth and percussion and vocals, please put your hands together for the incredible Camila. Joining me from New York City on synth and percussion and vocals, please put your hands together one more time for the incredible Melissa McMillan. I'm joined from County Kerry in Ireland by the MD of this band on bass and synth and vocals. Please put your hands together with the incredible Alex Ryan. And joining me from Dublin, Ireland on drums and percussion and vocals is the incredible, indelible Dr. Rory Doyle. And he is a practicing unlicensed doctor. You can catch him at the merch stall later on tonight. scripts to beat the band. I want to say a huge thank you to all of our incredible crew. Steve Patterson, front of house engineer, thank you for mixing this gig. Steve Patterson. Our wonderful lighting engineer, Joseph Eli Morris, aka Bambi, thank you, Joseph. My incredible guitar technician, Mr. Mert Murphy, thank you, Mert. Incredible bass and drum technician, Mr. Fred Burke, thank you, Fred. Incredible backline tech with string keys and guitar. Wonderful Mark Ryan, thank you, Mark. Incredible monitor engineer, Hunter Scoggins, thank you, Hunter. Thank you to Chris on audio, thank you, Chris. Respect you. And Carson on audio at front, thank you very, very much. And Shane on audio here, thank you. Thank you very much to our wonderful tour manager, Duchess Iredale. Our wonderful band manager, Sherry Kushner. Our wonderful production manager, Nick Laurie. Our incredible production assistant, Sinead Madden. Thank you all. Thank you, Caroline Henry here with management. Thank you, Caroline. Colleen Wittenberg is directing these screens. Thank you, Colleen. And our wonderful camera team, Paul and Freddie. Thank you very much. Not to mention, our wonderful photographer, Ruth Medjberg. Thank you, Ruth. Our head of security, Rob, keeping an eye on me. Keeping me out of trouble. Keeping you guys safe. Thank you to keeping me away from Rory's script. I want to say a huge thank you to Kitty Hoffman, our crew boss, and Kevin Wyatt also. Thank you very, very much. And our wonderful carpenters, Michael and Shivers. Thank you. And Dana on the merch store. Thank you very much, Dana. Yeah. And there's so much more. Everybody's name is going to be on the screen behind us. It takes a huge village of well over 50 people. So thank you all to our incredible crew. And now an excerpt from War and Peace. I do want to say one final huge thank you, and if I could hear an enormous round of applause for this incredible artist who's going to join us for this last number. Put your hands together for the incredible Allison Russell.
My baby and my baby will hit me.
baby. She put her love down soft and sweet. In the lonely night I was free. Heaven and heaven was to me.
Thank you so much, Ben. We'll see you again soon. Thank you very much. So, thank you.